Changing the size of the objects proportionally is something that we may also need to do a couple of times while working. For example, we may need to enlarge an object in a way that it will be double in size. By the same reasoning, we could also reduce an object size, let's say to half of the original size. To do so, we will use the Scale tool. The Scale tool can be found either in the Modify menu or in the Modify panel of the Home ribbon. Once I activate the tool, a message prompts me to select the object I wish to scale. I will select the item that has been drawn in the first example and press Enter. Another message appears, which prompts me to specify the base point. I will click on the lower left corner of the shape I selected to define it. Next, I have to define the scale factor. Notice that as I move the cursor, the size of the shape changes accordingly. In this example, I want to reduce its size to half, so I will type the number 0.5 and then I will press Enter. As you can see, the object now is smaller. I will activate the command again, select the same object and press Enter. I will set the same base point as before and look at the command line. I am given two options, the copy option and the reference option. By selecting copy, the scaled object will be a copy of the original, while the initial object will remain the same. So I will click on the copy option and notice that now the preview that appears as I'm moving the cursor does not affect the object I have selected to scale. This time, I want to create an object 3 times bigger than the one I selected. So, I will type the number 3 and press Enter. As you can see, the scaled object is indeed a copy and the initial object has not changed. Moving on to the next examples, I'm going to show you how the reference option works and how we can use this option in a project. As you can see, in this drawing, there's a simple room's floor plan with a bed in it. Let's say I want to scale the bed in such a way that its upper side reaches the wall. I will activate the Scale command, select the bed, and press Enter. I will set the base point to the lower left corner of the bed. In this case, though, I do not know the exact scale factor that will enlarge the bed as much as needed to reach the wall. To make this work, I need to use a reference in combination with the intersection snap. So I will activate the intersection from the snaps list, and then I will click on the reference option in the command line. I will use as a reference the left side of the bed, so I will click on the lower left corner first, and then on the upper left corner. Now the bed size is increasing using as a reference the length of the bed. In this way, when the cursor goes close to the wall, the intersection snap appears. When I click on it, the bed size adapts accordingly and the result is exactly what I wanted. Now, let's see another example where I'm going to use the reference option. Imagine that you have imported a drawing someone else created into your drawing and the size of the items is not right. To give you a better picture of what I mean, a ship's hull has been imported in the current drawing. However, the length of this boat doesn't seem right. I already know that its length should have been 19 meters, but as you can see, it is a lot bigger than that. I can scale it, but unfortunately, I do not know the scale factor. Since I know its current length, which is equal to 26.68 meters, and its actual length, which is equal to 19 meters, I could make some calculations to figure the scale factor out. However, that would take some time to achieve. So I can use its length as a reference and define the new length while scaling it. To do this, I will activate the Scale tool, select the boat, and set its base point on the left side of the deck. Then, I will type ref to activate the reference option and click on the two endpoints of the deck. Finally, I will type the number 19, which will be the new length, and press Enter. The scale process is finished, and now the board is indeed 19 meters long, as it should be.